Well, it's arguably the greatest night of the year for the PGBL. Why? The playoffs. You don't get to watch one great game. You get to watch two great games with four of the best teams in the league. That's my opinion. But, of course, we're going to hear it from somebody else who's here tonight to tell us all about it. Fatih Yiannopoulos. Fatih, welcome back. You're also playing. Let's take a look, or let's break down, actually, the first game, the Sixers and the Wolfpack.
First, I want to say it's great to be back. Living in New York is great, but coming back here to the PGBL, I've really missed these Thursday nights. I completely agree with you. These are the four best teams in the league that feature a lot of former champions, a lot of former MVPs. The first game is the Wolfpack versus the Sixers. The Wolfpack are 13-1 this year. By far the best record in the league. They have the league MVP in my mind in George Vlahos, very mature player, a guy that can take over the game at any point. The Sixers, on the other hand, have two very, very quality experienced players, Jim Armanakis and Chris Vassilio. We know what kind of damage they can do. They can put up 40, 50, 60 points in one night. So I'm really excited for this matchup.
Let me give you a little updated information. As of this evening, we were told Lou Karras will not be here and Lou Sarris Grau will not be here. Two of the starters for the team. I'm assuming that's going to change our perspective on the game. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, you have a leader, the point guard being out, and then you have the defensive player of the year arguably being out. So that's a huge advantage for the Sixers. If I'm the Wolfpack, though, they're a lot younger, a lot quicker. They have to use that to their advantage and get a lot of easy baskets and try to wear the Sixers down. But it's not going to be easy because the Sixers are experienced and they have won before.
Well, there we have it. All right, let's talk about game two here. Danny's boys and the Kings. It's sort of a rematch. Two things, two thoughts come to me, two players. Of course, Bill Zonius, a guy who's been looking for his championship the whole 8-9 years of the league, and Pete Kathopoulos. He's been here 2 years in a row. Danny's boys has won the championship. Now they're looking for the third. Let's get a breakdown on your thoughts on that.
Ah, that hits a sore spot for me. Danny's boys slash Spurs, we've lost to them 3 straight years in the playoffs, but there's a reason. They have dynamic players on their team, as you said, with Pete Kathopoulos, who scored 41 on Sunday against the Revolution. He's the most electrifying player in the league. He could score 50 if he wants. But they do have some depth. They have Costa Nicolos, they have Dimitri Poulimenos, and those two were key in their championship run last year. So the Kings are not just going to have to focus on one player. They have quite a few that they need to hone in on. So
what do you think the difference will be tonight in game two?
Well, somebody came in from out of state tonight, so I think that's going to be the difference, and I got to give the edge to the Kings.
There you have it from Fatih. Fatih, welcome back. All right, well, now let's talk to some of the players from both the Sixers and the Wolfpack. Well, we're with one of the senior players of the Sixers, longtime friend, and one of the co-founders of the league, John Vassilio. John, you've got the Wolfpack. You've been to the championship. You've been to the big show before, as they say. What's the strategy for this evening?
You know, we won a championship a few years ago, and playoffs time where you got to play your best. And last week against the Warriors, we played our best game of the year. So we just got to build on that, and we got to play these guys tough. They're a little bit undermanned today, but we still got to play them tough. Tight defense, no turnovers, and team basketball. So we're ready. We're ready. It's playoff time.
There it is from John Vassilio. Now let's talk to one of the players from the other team. But we're talking with one of the men who has the longest syllable names in the league. Karapanagiotides. Did I get it right?
Yeah, you did.
Well, Evan, tell us about tonight. You guys are playing a little shorthanded.
Well, we are playing a little shorthanded, but with our team, that doesn't matter. You know, everybody comes, brings their A game every time we play. And, you know, we do our best every time. And that's what always gets us to the win. We only have one thing in mind tonight, and that's win.
Win. Who's going to be running the show out front?
Well, Coach Yoti.
Coach Yoti. Okay, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
So let's take a look now at some of the action from game one, the Wolfpack versus the Sixers.
1, 2, 3.
Wolfpack!
1, 2, 3, Sixers!
Set it up.
Set it up.
Set it up.
76-61, the Wolfpack will be in the championship game next week. George Vlachos, the first half, you were there, you played the game, you had a few buckets, but the second half, you really poured it on. You came out with 23 points. You guys really stuck it out tonight, especially without the two lose. How do you feel about the victory?
Man, I feel great. A lot of people counted us out tonight. They thought we were going to lose because we were missing a few guys, but, I mean, that obviously wasn't the result, so.
All right, congratulations to you. Let's go on now and talk to some of the players from Danny's Boys and the Kings. I'm with Nick Varonis, last year's MVP, and one of the players from the runner-up team, the Kings. Nick, tonight's the night. You get to play them again. This time, it's a semifinal game. How do you feel, and what's the strategy?
I feel ready to go. We got a full team here for once. We've had a lot of guys missing throughout the games and throughout this season, so we have 10 guys here. We're ready to go. It's always a good game with these guys. They're a resilient team. They're a team of runs, so we can't get complacent or content at all, and we just got to play our game.
All right, there you have it from Nick. They're ready. Now let's talk to somebody from Danny's Boys. Anthony, tonight you guys are returning champs. Give us a few thoughts about the challenges tonight against the other guys.
Well, I mean, we played two really competitive games against them during the course of the year. One, we were a little bit shorthanded, obviously, but that first game way back in October, really right down to the wire. I think we're really starting to click. Last week we had a really good game, a quarterfinal matchup against a really great Revolution team, so hopefully we can feed off of that momentum and carry it here today.
So great to win. If you could win it three times, it would be quite a charm, as they say, a hat trick. Good luck to you guys tonight.
Thank you very much.
Now let's take a look at some of the action from Game 2, Danny's Boys and the Kings.
One, two, three, Danny's Boys!
Great, great time to try.
Pete, I gotta tell you, I've never seen a performance like that in this gymnasium. You carried your team at the very end. You did everything you could. You still have two championships, maybe next year, but an incredible performance today. You must be exhausted.
Yeah, I'm a little tired. I just want to give a big shout out to my teammates. Fantastic job, guys, all year. I love you guys. We gave it everything we had. We were a little undermanned today. We were playing with six players, so I know for a fact if we had a full team, we would have won, guaranteed. It's just unforeseen circumstances. I want to thank my family for always coming to the games, my wife for always pushing me to practice. And again, to my teammates, I'm sorry, I tried hard. I wish we would have won.
I think everybody's happy with your performance and loves the fact that they get to see a player like you here in the league. Congratulations. It was a great season for you guys.
Yeah, it was a great season. Like I said, my hat goes out to the teammates, to my teammates. Thank you, guys. Good luck to the Wolfpack and Kings. Hope they have a good game. But like I said, I love my teammates, and we tried our best.
Thank you again, Pete. Thanks, congratulations for a great season.
Thank you. Thank you.
107-96 in overtime. You guys pulled it out. You came back from a 10-point deficit at halftime. What did you guys talk about at halftime that made the difference and brought it back?
We didn't really talk about much except the fact that we need to keep rotating our guys. We knew we were really deep, and that one day our depth is going to be our strength. And it was today because, as you can tell, they were a little bit worn out, and we had fresh legs coming in the whole time. So it really helped us.
Laz, you guys are returning to the championship. How does it feel to be going back again?
Hopefully we win this time. We've been there enough. We have to win. We have a really deep bench. We're going to
coach right here.
Listen.
Right here.
We're putting up 120 next time.
Nick, I got to ask you. I watched you guys play a man-to-man defense, but then at the second half, you went into a full court man-to-man against Pete. What was the idea behind doing that? Did you feel like you could stop him or at least slow him down?
I mean, I don't know if you could stop Pete. He's a very, very, very talented player, but I mean, with six guys, it's tough. You got to get tired eventually. So I personally thought if I just put pressure on him full court, eventually he would get tired. And I mean, he started missing a few shots, but then he got on again at the end. And it was tough because I got four fouls eventually, too. So I had to try to stay in front without fouling. But it was a complete team effort today. And we're happy to pull it out. I said in the beginning, they're a resilient team. They kept fighting back. We fought back, and it was a back and forth game. But
how painful was it for you to watch that last second shot, that three-pointer that brought them into overtime?
He really banked that in, man. That was a tough shot, but that's what you expect from a player like Pete. And if we didn't pull that game out in overtime, I don't know if Bill would ever got over that layup he missed at the end of regulation. But thankfully, we pulled it out, and we'll enjoy this win for now going into the championship.
All right. 107-96, a final. Danny's boys will not retain their third title, but an outstanding performance, a once-in-a-lifetime performance here at the gym to see Pete Kothopoulos score 57 points, carrying his team into overtime. A great season for Danny's boys. Unfortunately, being shorthanded did pay its price. The Kings are going to be returning to the championship next week right here after a great game. They'll be playing the Wolfpack. Both teams have the depth to play the game all the way through. It'll be a great game. I'm Lefteddy Constance. We'll see you next week here at the PGBL Championship at St. Demetrius.